Hello there and welcome to this program. Today is Monday, 16 March, and we are talking about what is happening, how this world pandemic has destroyed many lives and how it's going to affect Africa. So if you following the news, you find out that here in South Africa, COVID-19 has been declared a national disaster by the president, and they've put in measures. And some of the measures are that gatherings have been limited to only 100 people per gathering. So if you are planning a wedding in this coming future, sorry, you have now to limit only by invitation. So there are so many people that are going to be affected. Those guys who are musicians are going to be affected because they can't. They are not going to have bigger crowds like they always do, which means they have to cancel their bookings. They beat somebody who has, or even state theaters, they are going to be limited. So which means that the actors that are supposed to be, you know, acting in these state theaters, they are also going to be adversely affected. The church leaders, you know, if they are church leaders who depend on, you know, the church to get their livelihood, they are going to be adversely affected. But you know, they are loyal people who keep on giving their tithes and their offerings, because some of them, they are going to be addressing their people live online. But it's not everyone who has got access to the internet. It's fairly the go-go's and the old elderly people who just go to the church. They don't have a smartphone. So church leaders who are dependent on their members, they are going to be adversely affected. Musicians, they are going to be adversely affected. In the lectures, some universities have actually suspended lectures, and people are going to be just studying online. A lot of things have happened. So I was talking to a doctor this morning, and I want you to take a listen to this audio that I was talking to her, and I'm gonna come back again after this, and then we talk more about people that are affected and how it's going to impact your pocket. So stay tuned and listen to this audio.
The question that I had was, the first one was that there've been no record of an African man who has died of coronavirus, but there are others that have been infected with it.
Yeah.
And does this, is this just a myth, or we haven't been exposed to it to such an extent that it can be able to kill us? What is your take on that?
I think, as I was saying, the deaths recorded from the virus are actually not that high. So I think if caught in the early on, once you've been infected, I don't see why someone should die from it.
Yeah.
In the beginning in China, when people were dying, it was still quite an elusive condition that people didn't know much about, didn't know how to manage, didn't know. The knowledge about it wasn't that high. That's why people were dying. But I don't think now, as much as we should take precautions, it seems like with the precautions and with the correct management, the prognosis is quite good.
Okay. So there have been, as I was saying earlier, that, you know, there have been conspiracies about this whole thing, that this thing came from Wuhan province, which is close to a lab, and this thing probably could have been man-made, something that was meant to target some, some certain kind of people, or doing economic sabotages on China. What do you think about that? Do you think this thing was man-made, or it was not? It was just something that broke out from somewhere.
That's a tough one. I'd hate to think that someone went and created a virus that is now like killing people.
Yeah.
So I don't know. Yeah. I don't know. I don't want to believe that it was man-made.
Yeah.
Although I don't know how it started, to be honest.
or just a catastrophic mistake.
Yeah, maybe. But I mean, all viruses sort of originate somewhere.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't know. I have enough knowledge to comment on where it's come from.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You have said to me that the you are not scared of the virus itself, but you are scared of the ramifications that you have there of to the economy.
Yes.
And to people's life in general.
Yes.
Do you think we are very much prepared to deal with it as a virus, or we are going to be much affected by our lives are going to be affected much by the coronavirus economic, and what do you think?
Sure. So I think just from a health sector perspective,
yeah,
I don't think the hospitals are really equipped,
yeah,
to handle the virus. I mean, a lot of our hospitals are
make a slight left turn on only the Bosch Road.
Yeah.
Have way few staff compared to, you know, compared to patients and very little resources. So I think like
in 300 meters, make a slight left turn on 11 Bosch Avenue.
If it becomes a big pandemic,
yeah,
I think it could put a lot of strain on the healthcare system that's already overburdened.
Yeah.
In terms of the general public, I think it was what I was saying earlier, that I mean, if they start to restrict capacities of public spaces, it could really affect a lot of people's jobs, which is a bit concerning.
Yeah.
And also like when they shut down things, like a lot of people earn sort of charge jobs,
yeah,
and stuff like that. It's not like a set salary where they get paid at the end of the month. So
they work on a daily basis.
On a daily basis, you know, and if jobs are closed down, for people that do charge jobs, it could have a dire effect on them.
Yeah.
And I mean, the illnesses associated with hunger and with things like that can be a little bit worse than
So we might have a situation whereby after coronavirus we might have even a bigger problem,
exactly,
in terms of like feeding the nation,
exactly,
in terms
exactly
of like issues to do with malnutrition or in some places,
exactly.
Then there is this thing about just Africa in general, we're struggling with the HIV.
Mm.
And the number of people that have been affected with HIV, are many.
Yes.
The numbers are many. And from what I've heard, like this coronavirus, it can affect you badly if your immune system is not good.
Mm.
How bad it is for somebody who has got HIV and AIDS, what are the consequences? Are they... How can they survive such a virus?
So generally, I mean, it's not just HIV, it's anything that lowers your immune system. So even things like diabetes, if it's not controlled.
Yeah.
HIV and AIDS, even that, it's HIV and AIDS that's not controlled.
Yeah.
A person who's taking their treatment has quite a good immune response.
Yeah.
When they catch any viruses.
Yeah.
But yeah, they definitely won't be able to fight off the virus as well as they should. Because the actual cells in the body that are meant to fight off the virus don't work as well as they should.
Yeah.
So I think that's another thing. Like I don't know, for now it seems like the way it's portrayed in society, it seems like coronavirus is affecting like rich people.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
luckily it hasn't, I mean, maybe not luckily, but I mean, it hasn't affected people that are immunocompromised as such. And I think once it goes into the townships, then you could have, they could be quite problematic, because a lot of them are immunocompromised, a lot of them can't access healthcare.
Yeah.
And also they live in such congested conditions that the risk of it spreading is so high. Like, how do you quarantine someone that is living in a one-room house with 10 other people?
Yes, and also the other thing is they don't eat their health habits. They don't have good health habits.
Like, a lot of them don't even have water to wash their hands. So I think if it starts going into township, then it can be actually very scary.
Now, with the economic ramifications that this virus is putting on the stock market, and do you think people can give their money in order to save a few, or people will be a bit stingy?
I mean, I think there are always people with too much money, to be honest.
Yeah.
So I think, yeah, it's worthwhile to invest and the people that can, the people that have the means, to support those that have a little bit less. If that's the direction that people should go, especially to prevent it spreading as quickly as it would spread, then I think it's a good idea, definitely.
Alright, Tseho, it was good chatting to you.
Thank you. It was a good ride.
Okay, alright. I really appreciated your time and what you've given me.
It's a pleasure. I hope you have good content.
Alright, no, I'll do that. Like, I'll do that.
Alright.
Alright. Have a great weekend.
Thank you too.
Alright.
Okay, so that is the audio that I was talking to Doctor, obviously, because she was not dressed up well. So we decided to record an audio instead of a video instead. So, who is going to benefit and who is going to lose? In this world pandemic, there are many people who are going to benefit and there are many people who are going to lose. The people that are going to benefit, the people that are going to buy shares this time in time, because the share price is going to go down for many companies. I know the share price for Sasol here in South Africa has gone down from 435 to about 31 rands. So it has been badly impacted. But the person who's going to buy those shares right now, they are going to benefit in the long run. So the people that are going to buy shares at this time, because the share price is going to go down and you can buy more shares and then you can reap the dividends later, these are the people that are going to benefit. You know, a new business has actually come up, the business of selling hand sanitizers, tissues, the business of selling face masks. So these people, they are going to benefit a lot from this. So in spite of all this, everyone has to fight for survival because the economy is going to be adversely affected. So these are the things that you in this time, even my company is Uber, they've closed all the GLH hub, the green light hubs all over South Africa. All of them, they've been shut down. So it means that many people have been affected. So the people that are working for Uber at the offices, they are not going to get paid for these days unless they are working remotely otherwise. But they are going to be grossly affected because this is a forced leave and the company is not going to be making much profit. So they won't be paid for these days and it's going to affect much of the people, but there are some people who are going to benefit. So what are you going to do? Are you going to sit and wait to be affected, or are you going to find ways of survival? This is the time for you to look out for survival skills in this time. So I thought I should just share this with you. Look for something to do, either buy shares, sell something, go online and be able to advertise your business that has got something to do with the COVID-19. So I believe that you are not going to sit and relax and wait for problem to come. You are going to step up and find something to do, because when there is a catastrophe, someone is benefiting. Just like at a funeral, you are crying that your loved one is gone, but someone is smiling that they've got business. So are you going to be the funeral parlor, or you are going to be the person that is crying? So you choose, the ball is in your court. I'll see you next time. Please subscribe to JCTV Zimbabwe. And if you're on Twitter, Instagram, please follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Thank you.